We're on the road again, traveling the country coast to coast to check out the latest in decarbonization. This week, we're in beautiful Cleveland, Ohio, where our partners have lots of solutions to share. Let's rock and roll!
You know what the best thing is about going on these road trips for Maria?
Let's hear it.
Getting to eat at all the local institutions.
I know, what a perk. I'm excited to dive in.
So we're here at Larder, known for pastrami. I'm wondering, do you think they'll let me slide down the fire pole?
You know, if you play your cards right, I'll cover you.
All right, well, let's see where Maria's gonna send us today.
All righty.
Hi, John and Bree. Your next stop is Cleveland Clinic. Their philosophy is that decarbonization is inherently linked to their healthcare strategy. In places like the pathology lab and in operating rooms, I know it'll be helpful for others to learn from what they're doing. So let's get moving.
All right. It'll be exciting to kind of get behind the scenes at the hospital a little bit.
To scrub in, hopefully, at some point.
Yeah, I'm ready. Scalpel.
Yeah.
John and Bree, welcome to Cleveland Clinic. Cleveland Clinic is a nationally ranked multi-specialty academic medical center. This is our main campus. This is principal driver of our energy consumption and therefore our carbon footprint. The healthcare industry discharges about 8% of the nation's carbon. And so we view that carbon reduction, energy efficiency, all those things are directly linked to patient outcomes, particularly in urban environments like the one we find ourselves in.
Yeah, like urban heat island effect and things like that.
And there are peer-reviewed studies that directly link heat, pollutants, carbon discharge to patient outcomes and the health of communities.
Well, it's great to have you here at our health education campus. This is an incredible building. I'll tell you why. It's just flush with all kinds of innovation, including energy innovation. The most important part of this building is that we took four different schools and put them under one roof. By putting them under one roof, we've saved the amount of building by 40%, embedded carbon by 45%. We reduced the amount of energy to build the building. And then it's cheaper to operate because you got all the people under one roof. We made it really energy efficient.
It's really impressive.
Welcome to our simulated operating room.
All right, we're in scrubs. What's in store for us today?
You're looking good, right there. Before you enter the operating room, you gotta wash your hands.
Okay.
By your left knee, there is a water dispenser. Just tap that. At the Cleveland Clinic, we have a very easy knee water sensor, so you could easily turn it on and off. And we've done a lot of education in turning the water off at the scrub sink when you're not using it. And here we are in the simulated operating room. You'll be playing our patient today.
Okay, hopefully no surgery.
I don't know, we'll see about that.
In this space in particular, obviously a very unique environment, what are some of the challenges and ways you're addressing energy efficiency?
One thing we can talk about is our OR setbacks. The operating room is a sterile environment, and we have to exchange air every hour to do that and to mitigate infection risks. Prior to our interventions, we were exchanging air up to 35 times an hour. We have now reduced our air exchanges to about 20 an hour when an OR is in use and 6 when not in use. And in doing that, we've reduced about 58,000 tons of carbon and saved about $6 million.
How do you know, like, measures that you mentioned, such as OR setbacks and others, are effective in the work that you're doing?
In the operating room, you can actually look and see your efficiency and see these setbacks in use and see the number of air exchanges. And then we also have kind of like a mission control, a command center. We can see what all of the operating rooms throughout our campuses are doing, and we can make sure that we're staying within code so that we're maximizing patient safety and continuing to maximize that energy efficiency as well.
I've also heard that certain anesthetic gases can be pretty potent greenhouse gases.
Since 2011, Cleveland Clinic has eliminated desflurane from our system, and that's about 24 times more emitting than any of our other anesthetics. We really promote the use of regional and local anesthetics, and that decreases our overall use of inhaled anesthetics like isoflurane, sevoflurane, or nitrous oxide. John, you've been such a great patient. Bree, you've been so wonderful as well.
Thank you.
Have these tokens of our appreciation.
Oh, thank you so much.
Delicious. Cheers.
Well deserved.
I want to welcome you to our laboratory building. We process about 20 million tests annually here. There are definitely specific challenges, and if you want to come along to the lab, I can show you some in person.
Wonderful. Let's go.
Let's go.
So the fume hoods themselves, there's certain settings for the ventilation, but when the caregivers are done doing the procedures that they need to do inside the fume hood, they will then close the sash. So we call it a shut the sash campaign. And by shutting the sash, they're not having the outdoor air mixing with this indoor air. We've saved about $30,000 by shutting the sash. And we've also saved about 480 tons of carbon. The roof is solar ready. We have plans to install solar in the next 1 to 2 years. And we already have solar installed on several other of our Cleveland Clinic buildings. The other part of the roof is a green roof, which helps with stormwater drainage and runoff, which is a big problem in Northeast Ohio. Along with the permeable pavers that we have, we're able to help the stormwater enter into the groundwater more quickly and avoid flooding.
That was exciting. I thought it was really cool to hear all about how they view decarbonization as not just something to do for the planet, but as something to do for the health of their patients.
And it was awesome to get to see from a lot of the folks we spoke with how sometimes even what may seem like the smallest measure has a huge impact, such as actions like shutting the sash in a laboratory setting. I wonder where Maria's gonna send us next.